สวัสดีค่ะ I'm สดชื่นลิมเกรียงไกร and welcome to Be My Guest the program that brings you successful stories of institutions and entrepreneurs in both international and domestic arena In today's episode we will be talking to our participants from different countries who are at 12th ASEAN skill competition hosted in Thailand to compete in different categories let's find out more about them right nowJoining us today is Mr. Suthi Sukhosun, Director General of Department of Skill Development. สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ
Thank you for joining us today. First of all, let me ask you about how the ASEAN Skill Competition started.
ASEAN Skills Competition takes place every 2 years.
Okay.
So 10 member countries of ASEAN turns around to be the host of the competition. This year,Thailand is honored with hosting the 12th ASEAN competition this year. So this is our 12th competition this year, and Thailand will be the host of this competition. So this year, Police Major General Odun Sang Singkao, the Minister of Labor, gives the policy to the Ministry of Labor, the Department of Skill Development, to.Organize this competition to be efficiently, and he would like all the competitors to compete fairly, and to welcome all the 10 or the 9 member countries to be our. He would like us to be the best host of this competition.
I see. Well, talking yes. about you know Thailand readiness to host this competition.How ready do you think Thailand is to host this competition here?
In fact, this is our second time that we host the ASEAN competition. So I think that we are very ready to welcome all the 9 member countries. Starting from the airport, we send our liaison to welcome all the delegates, and we take good care of them to the hotels.And take good care of the competitors to come to this event. Then this today is the first day of the competition. Okay. Yesterday, the opening ceremony took place at the Impact Mueang Thong Thani Arena yesterday, just next to our challenger. This is the competition place, and the arena is the opening place of the competition. And the opening was.Preciously opened last night.
I see.
And I think that all the competitors, all our delegates were very happy with the opening ceremony. We celebrate the beginning of this competition, and today we start the competition this morning.
I
think that all the competitors are doing very well, and they are trying their bestTo become the best of ASEAN,
of course,
among them, and among themselves,
yes.
and they are doing very well so far. As far as I see, they are trying to be the best of ASEAN.
I see. That's great indeed. So, what about the concept this year? What is the concept revolves around?
The competition aims at improving the youth skill standard, and of course, the competitiveness of this region.Because we hope that our investor would come to our region to invest so that we have to prepare our workforce starting from the youth. The competitors are the youth and they have to be well prepared to be the efficient workforce for our future economic development. And this event, this competition is a very good arena for our competitors.To try their skills, to improve their skills, and finally to become the efficient workforce for the region.
So, speaking about the competition itself, how many categories are there in this competition?
This year, we are going to have 26 skill areas that the competitors are going to take the test projects this year.
I see.
And these these are all those 26 skills that are very, very needed for this year investment and economic growth. So I think that all these 26 skill areas are very proper and very, very in time that we put in the test projects this year.
I see. So how do you think Thailand benefits from hosting this competition this year?
Of course, all those 26 areas are very needed for the investment, and Thailand is going to grow in terms of the economic development. And I think that it's a policy of the government that we are going to give high importance to the engine of growth that we need to improve our competitiveness, especially in the field of the robotics, digital area, in terms of service and hospitality, which is very, very important for our tourism. And the last one is mechatronic, CNC, which are very, very important for the economic development and investment.
I see. So is there any expectations for the competition this year?
I think that we are trying our best to win all the 26 areas.
Of course.
Because I think that our competitors are trying very, very hard, and they are doing very well as far as I can see them from this morning. However, our competitors in 9 member countries are also very good. So I think that this will be the fair competitive competition and a fair game for our younger generation in ASEAN member countries to try their best to become the best of ASEAN.
I see. Well, it's going to be a very fun competition, but at the same time, very close competition indeed. And hopefully Thailand will win so many medals as well.
Yes.
Well, thank you so much for joining us today and sharing with us the information. ขอบคุณค่ะ
ขอบคุณครับ สวัสดีครับ
Here is a place where amazing is never ending. Everywhere has a charming Thai way of life. Every moment is filled with joy and truly refreshes the soul. Every sense is awakened with unforgettable flavors to tempt your taste buds. Only a smile can make friends for no reason. Let's experience Thai-ness and
When holidaying in Thailand, get up at the break of dawn. Give alms. Make merit. Sip a local coffee brew.Then climb a palm tree in the middle of a field. Learn to harvest crops with local farmers. Taste the refreshing sap and juice. Get a relaxing massage. Indulge in a spa session. And enjoy a Thai meal in the jungle. Ride a water buffalo. Wade in mud and plow the fields. Grow jasmine rice the traditional way.Bike downhill to tone those legs and pump that blood. Board a train. Eat at every station and take in the window seat views. Skillfully dye fabrics using nature's magnificent colors. Chat with villagers and share local fruits. Admire the old town on bicycles and rest the eyes. Laze around. Wake up! Kick a rattan ball around with Thai friends.Learn Thai boxing, help villagers paint boats, steer a fishing vessel, fish for food, dive with whale sharks, prepare rice vermicelli, whip up Thai sweets, study koan dance and shadow puppetry, make traditional medicine and nurse yourself, jam with a Thai band, jump into a private pool, join a Thai temple fair at night. tease the cat in the evening and enjoy midnight stir-fried morning glory like a true local. Discover your unique local experiences in amazing Thailand.
สวัสดีค่ะ. Thank you for joining us today. First of all, let me ask you to introduce yourself. Where are you from?
I'm from Malaysia.
Okay, and which category are you participating
in? I'm beauty therapy.
And your name?
My name is Misha Lini, so call me Misha.
I see. Well, can you tell us a little bit about your skill, how you started entering the skill?
How I started? Actually, I have interest in doing nail art and everything. So when I joined to do nail art, so my principal asked me to try whole beauty skills. Mm. So I tried myself. So I came here today.
I see. How long ago was that?
Nearly 1 year plus.
Well, that's not long actually to actually start everything and be here.
Yeah.
So were there any awards that you've received before entering this competition?
Yes. I joined in Asian competition first to before I come here. Mm-hmm. So I get bronze medal from Asia, and other than that, I have silver for henna competition.
Okay.
Yeah, that's it.
I see, and that all of that was in Malaysia.
Yeah, all of that in Malaysia.
I see. So let's talk about the process of being chosen to be the representative of Malaysia in the ASEAN level, which is, you know, a big deal here.
Yeah.
So can you tell us a little bit about the process that you have to go through?
It's quite hard because when I train, I don't used to like it. Here is most, everyone has skills. Mm. So here they will see our safety and hygiene more.
Okay.
I have to like, If I touch a chair, also I have to sanitize my hand, like everything.
I see.
So there's a lot of procedures to do actually.
So
it's quite hard.
I see. So it's more about the little things.
Yeah, little things.
I see. Yeah. So how many competitions did you have to go through before, you know, being chosen?
Three.
Three.
What
are they? Can you tell us a bit about that?
We call us as a pre-competition at Malaysia.
Mm-hmm.
Then you have to go for finals.
Mm-hmm.
Then Asian here.
I see.
Yeah.
So since it's a big thing and it's a big stage, let's say, how did you prepare yourself for this competition?
Actually, first, you must have the interest.
Of course. The passion, basically.
Yeah, passion. So, and at first, for serious, I don't have that passion. So my principal showed me the row, how to go and everything. So I went through all that, and of course, I get schooled many times and everything.
Of course, it's part of the process.
Yeah.
I see.
So quite hard also.
I see. So how would you say, how ready are you for this competition?
I'm 99%.
Where's the 1%?
Because it's 30% of changes, so there's a lot to think actually.
I see.
Yeah.
So you just finished from one of the competition.
Yeah.
Here.
I.
The first round.
Yeah,
basically.
First round.
So
Can
you tell us what did you have to go through?
Okay. The hardest part is toweling. So the amount of towel that I use in my training, that's not given here.
Okay. So they count the amount of towels you used as
well?
That's interesting.
Yeah. So here I don't get that much of amount, so I have to manage.
Did you get?
Normally I'll use like 13 small towels.
Okay.
They only give me 10, so like two are missing.
Not too much difference.
But the use of important is quite a lot.
I think so. For you it might be a lot. I see. So let's talk about your skill here.
Yes,
since you know, you had like a long road, basically. You told us that, you know, you had a problem with your passion, with the overall beauty thing here. So what do you think, how or even how do you think this skill would take you in the future?
Okay, my parents actually. Because I took electrical engineering first.
Okay, which is totally different.
Totally different, yes. Yeah. So after that, I couldn't, actually my mother is one of the senior to enter the electrical engineering. So
okay.
she forced me to do that.
Of course.
So I have no interest in that. My skills are more to colors, arts and everything. So when I joined to nail art and nail course, then my principal asked to go here. So why not I try?
Yeah.
And my passion is I want to achieve something for my parents. So I tried it.
I see.
And I'm standing here today. They are proud of me.
Of course.
Yeah.
So what would you say is your strongest selling point compared to the other competitors here?
My strongest point? I like to smile.
Oh, that's a good thing.
Yeah. And yeah, of course it's nervous, but I don't show it.
Yeah, that's also a good thing. So, you know, everyone has a different, let's say, skill here that they're good at, which is, let's say, some people are good at spa treatment, some people are good, like you say, nail art.
Yeah.
So when it comes to here, what do you think is the,
of course,
the most important thing that they should have to win this competition?
Of course, they must have skills, the basic skills.
Yeah.
Moreover, they have to know the safety and hygiene of the beauty. Because normally they will do like saloon type of things, so competition and saloon type is totally different actually.
I see.
They have to know what is that. Sure, they can do.
I see.
Yeah.
I see. So what do you think about this competition itself? How do you think it can open up doors for you?
Sorry?
Like, does it create more opportunities for you by entering this competition?
Of course. Like, now I'm entering here, so when I study, I have to pay my loan also because I took loan for my studies.
I see.
If I take something from my Malaysia, sure they will pay me something so I can settle up my loans and everything. And also, I can become a good trainer for Malaysia and I can teach the others, my juniors actually.
Definitely. Yeah. You, of course, you'll be a good teacher with lots of experiences now in
hand.
Yeah,
sure.
And lastly here, what about for some few words for the younger generation who wants to be like you or maybe they don't know the passion or the right way to go?
Yeah, this is the most important question. Like, normally parents, like, they were forced to ask to study doctor, lawyer, something else, right? Actually, that's wrong. They have to choose their skills or they have to choose what they like. There's nothing like you have to study for this, then you can earn. Even skills can earn money more.
I see. Passion is more important.
Yes.
I see. Well, unfortunately, that's all the time we have. Thank you so much for coming in and sharing with us your experience.
Thank you.
ขอบคุณค่ะ. สวัสดีค่ะ. Thank you for joining us today. First of all, can you introduce yourself?
Yes, I'm Henry Chamlan. I'm 21 years old. I came from Philippines.
I see. So which category are you participating?
I'm participating in a category on welding technology.
I see. Can you tell us about your skill and how you started?
I started from my school and I learned it so from more than 1 year.
Okay.
I can improve my skills and I love welding. That's why I'm here.
I see. So since you represent Philippines in this competition, which is a very big competition.
Yes.
So can you tell us about the process of how were you chosen? Why did they choose you?
They chose me because I'm a winner from provincial skills competition, regional skills competition, then zonal skills competition for Philippines.
I see. So how do you think how well you are prepared to compete in this competition?
I'm so prepared, especially for myself, for a healthy living, and for my skills also. I also prepared much.
I see. So talking about your skill, how did you prepare yourself for this? Did you practice more or what did you do to prepare for this?
I do more practices and I just have more than 6 months to practice, then I already need to beat the standards. That's how I prepare.
I see. Well, lastly here, for our viewers who may be, you know, from the Philippines maybe, who are looking at you and maybe want to be like you to compete in such a stage here, what would you say would be the best way to do so? Your advice?
For me, just dream big and put yourself into your skills, then love your skills, and don't stop practicing and learn more, and to improve your skills and just enjoy.
I see. Well, thank you so much for coming in. ขอบคุณค่ะ.
Thank you. Thank you.
Welcome to Thailand, the land for those who believe in equality. Believe that our world has no walls. The land that you can be opened to the taste you never imagined. Open yourself to different activities. Open your mind to countless unique ways of life. Open yourself to see millions of shades. Shades that are available for everyone to embrace, to feel, to love. Shades that make you realize that diversity is amazing. Open to the new shades. Amazing Thailand.
When holidaying in Thailand, relaxing in a spa session, enjoy a Thai meal in the jungle. Climb a palm tree, taste the refreshing sap and juice, board a train, take in the window seat views, chat with villagers, dive with whale sharks, admire the old town on bicycles, jam with a Thai band, join a Thai temple fair at night, and enjoy stir-fried morning glory like a true local. Discover your unique local experiences in amazing Thailand.
สวัสดีค่ะ
สวัสดีครับ
Thank you for joining us today. First of all, can you introduce yourself?
Okay. My name is Phumin Hiransunthorn, or you can call me P. I am the fourth year student at Dusitani College. Study about hospitality industry in major of culinary art and kitchen management.
I see. So which category are you competing in this competition?
I do cooking.
I see.
Yes.
So can you tell us a little bit about your skill here? How did it started?
Actually, I have to go back 1 year ago.
Yeah.
I do a competition at the Thai Fake, TUCC Thai Fake 2016. And then I think that teacher, they see something in me and they invite me to join the cooking, like a competition cooking in the college, to the represent the college to compete again at the provincial.
I see, I see. So, you know, since you're representing Thailand in the ASEAN stage, which is a big stage here,
yes.
Can you tell us, you know, the process of being chosen and why are you chosen?
In this competition, we have to pass about three competition. Like in the college, the provincial,
yes.
They divide its 12 provincial,
okay.
Before to the nation,
I see.
National competition.
I see.
And after national competition, we go to ASEAN competition.
Okay, so it has to be three other
yes.
stages before this.
Yes.
So it has been a rough competition.
Yes.
Definitely.
Very.
And a long time, because it's three competitions,
yes.
right?
One year.
How did you prepare yourself for this competition?
This competition, I have a good coach. Can I mention his name?
Of course.
Yes, his name is Chatupon Jingni. So he is I think he is one of the best chefs in Thailand.
Mm.
And he has many knowledge and he passed on me. So he prepared me a lot. and I train a lot, about 2 or 3 months.
I see.
That is the, I think that is the hard work with to do the like a training.
Yes. Yes. Of course. So, how would you say how ready are you for this competition?
Actually, I have to know. I have to say that I'm so ready because I prepared this competition for about 2 and 3 months. No more ready. Like I can.
This is the top.
Yes.
Okay, I see. Very confident. That's a good thing. So, you know, since you've been competing with, you know, other competitors here, and you're basically cooking the same menu.
Yes.
So how are you unique from the other? How can you show your uniqueness in the competition?
I have to say that in this competition, we can do a unique dish.
I see.
We have to follow the rules, the strict rules. If they told us what they want, we to do, we have to do.
I see.
What thing we can do, we can do.
I see. So you have to follow the rules strictly.
Yes. The one who can follow the rules most, he is the winner.
Ah, okay, I see. So let me ask you about the competition itself. So today you just competed in the first stage.
Yes.
And there are 3 days.
Yes.
So can you tell us a little bit more about this?
Okay. There are 3 days of competition.
Mm-hmm.
The first day of my is the, they call module one.
Okay.
It's a vegetarian canapé and a lemon meringue tart.
Okay.
It's divided to two.
I see.
And next day is the module two.
Okay.
They divide to two. They have the seafood pasta and fish main course for the casual dining.
Mm-hmm.
And the last day, that is the third day, is the fine dining. They have the 3 courses of dish. The first course is a chicken consommé, and the second course is a main course lamb, and the last is the chocolate lava.
I see.
Yes.
I see. So there's a lot of things you have to do here.
Yes, it's 7 menus.
I see. But each day is, you know, divided into like 2 or 3.
2, 3. Yes.
I see. So lastly here, how would you advise your younger generation here who is looking at you and maybe want to follow your path but don't know where to start? What would be your advice?
Actually, I'm lucky because I know what I want to do in since I was young.
I see.
And I want to tell the younger people,
mm-hmm.
I think they should find themselves that what they want to do in the future. If they can fight it faster, they can do it faster and earlier than the others. So if you know what you want, you go straight, go through it. You find information, you ask for the people who knows, include me.
Mm.
Yes, you can ask me. I will help, and I think people that you ask will help you.
Well, unfortunately, that's all the time we have.
Yes.
Thank you so much for joining us and sharing your experience.
Thank you.
The 12th ASEAN Skills Competition aims to promote skills standards in the ASEAN region, as well as to motivate youths to develop their skills to meet international standards and current technology. Young talents from 10 ASEAN countries participating in the World Skills ASEAN Bangkok 2018 will compete for medals in 26 skills, such as automotive technology, cooking, electrical installations, electronics, hairdressing, Internet of Things, mobile robotics, and restaurant service. Well, that's all the time we have for this episode. Thank you for tuning in. See you again next time. สวัสดีค่ะ.